So you've calculated the circumference of the Earth. That's a huge accomplishment. But now, let's move on. Let's calculate the size of the Moon. Here I've drawn a little diagram of what's going on with the Earth, the Moon, and the Sun. Now, keep in mind, this is not to scale at all. In fact, the Sun should be way, way, way bigger and way, way, way further off the screen. In fact, if I drew this right, these rays would all be more or less completely parallel. So the idea behind measuring the size of the Moon is we can exploit the fact that lunar eclipses occur. Now, what's a lunar eclipse? Well, here's the Sun, and here are a few of its rays, which I've traced. And you can see that if you were in your spaceship flying around over here, or here, or there, you would be illuminated. You would be in the Sun's rays, and everything would be bright and wonderful. As soon as you got behind the Earth, however, things get dark. You're in the Earth's shadow. The same thing happens to the Moon. What we want to do is figure out how big is the Moon compared to the Earth, since we know the size of the Earth already. Can we fit 1, 2, 3 moons in one Earth shadow? If that were the case, then the Moon would be 1/3 the size of the Earth. Or is it 2 moons in the Earth's shadow, or 7, or 12? I don't know. Let's figure that out. So how are we going to answer this question? How many moons fit in the Earth's shadow? All we're going to do is time how long the Moon spends in the Earth's shadow, how long we can't see it for, during a total lunar eclipse. The longer time it spends, the smaller the Moon is compared to the Earth. Once I know how much time the Moon spends in the Earth's shadow, I can convert that into moon widths, let's call it. And so what do I mean by a moon width? I mean this distance here. That's one moon width. So we have to know, how long does it take the Moon to move from here over to here, to move one moon width in its orbit? We can answer that by noting the fact that the Moon has an angular size in the sky of about 0.5 degrees. And so what do I mean by that? If you're standing on Earth, and if you first look at the top of the Moon, then look at the bottom of the Moon, this angle here is 0.5 degrees. We also know that it takes 28 days for one complete orbit. So in 28 days, it's gone 360 degrees, so that means it's gone 720 moon widths, since each width is only 0.5 degrees, and 720 is twice 360, which means 28 days per 720 moon widths. And if we do some unit conversion, that works out to be 0.93 hours for one moon width. So every 0.93 hours, the Moon has moved one width over. So it's gone from here to here, or from here to here, etc. Now, I'm just going to give you the data. I'm going to tell you what we can observe, and you're going to have to do some thinking and probably some unit conversion to answer this question. The observed fact is the following. The Moon spends 205 minutes in eclipse. And what do I mean for the Moon to be in eclipse? Well, we start the eclipse timer when the Moon is completely in the Earth's shadow, and end it just as it's leaving the Earth's shadow. Okay, so we know the Moon takes 0.93 hours to go one moon width, and we know it spends 205 minutes in eclipse, and we know Earth's circumference is equal to 40,000 kilometers. Now I think you can answer the question, not how many moons fit in the Earth's shadow, do it one step better. What is the circumference of the Moon? Enter your answer here in kilometers.